Peter Holland, all right, Toronto boy from Brampton. He was played for Brampton. Battalions are up in North Bay now. Watch this, beautiful hand. Oh, pretty quick. Watch this, between the legs. Oh, beautiful. Played for Guelph, beautiful. Hey, Toronto boy, I'm just saying, from Ontario, I just thought I'd throw that in.
Well, Vancouver's having a tough time in their game, but there is a line that gives them some hope, Don.
Reminds me of the way L.A. plays in the playoffs. Watch these guys. Lyndon Day from Saskatchewan. Brad Richardson, who played in L.A. last year, from Belleville. Sean Mathias played. I watched them play for the Senators of Mississauga. They throw that puck around. And not there. Now, watch them this here. When was this? The other night?
Yep.
Watch this
three
here.
Three goals for the line. But
three
this is
line.
The shift.
Now, watch these guys. This is the way L.A. played in the playoffs last year. And if these guys can keep it up, they'll look so good tonight. But this is watch this. These guys work. Kids work like this. These aren't the Sedin twins. These, you know, and these guys work.
But
and that's the way to
good.
Do it, right?
Yes, it is, absolutely. And Willie Desjardins takes some hope out of the fact Cody Eakins got a nice goal in the Montreal-Dallas game. Okay, let's get to the hit last night. Keith Ballard on Corey Perry. You think it's a cheap?
No, I think Corey's watching right now. It's a hockey hit. He doesn't go that low. I know everybody thinks it here.
A little low like that.
He's hurt now. One of my favorites, Corey. He's helped off. Now, you're going to say Nate Thompson comes in and takes him on. And then you people that don't understand, you have to answer. Somebody has to go after him there. You're saying what, it was a clean hit. You don't understand. There's no sense in me talking about it. You don't hit a guy like that unless you answer the bell. You have to be. And if you don't understand it, there's no sense in me talking about it. You had to straighten him out.
Even Kyle Turris got hit today with a beauty, and Alex Chiasson stepped in and looked like he was
you
cut
have to. And I know you're saying it's a clean hit. You don't understand. You never will.
Grapes, last night the fans obviously watched you last week because there was an icing 50 seconds into the game. You should have heard him give it to the linesman, but we'll save that for another day. Michael Hutchison in net. Terrific.
Michael Hutchison, MVP in the playoffs of the American Hockey League. He's 5-0-1. I tell you, boy, this is really something. Watched him play, too. Look at that there. I mean, this guy, you wonder why these guys are Winnipeg. It looks like they could make the playoff. This is one of the reasons.
And their defense is all hurt, so it's all the more impressive. Buffalin was just great.
Yeah, and Buffalin was in front the other night, too. I won't get into that. But anyhow, Brian Little got a hat trick. One of my favorite guys. Watch this here. Led nice hat trick a guy. He's played for London. He was pretty good. Watch this here. That's another reason. That's why Winnipeg is doing what they did. They've got a good goaltending. You got to start with good goaltending to start with, and the guys like Brian will always pull you through.
The MP, Patrick Brown, remember we go up for the hockey game up in Barrie, and he's the star of that every summer, so he's terrific. Edmonton Oilers, Don, we're down to about 2 minutes, so I want to leave, obviously, time for Sean Béliveau, but for Edmonton with Craig McTavish coming out this week.
Well, here, this is a big deal. You can't panic right now. You might as well go. There's no sense. And the other night, the other day, somebody went on. I'm not going to mention the guy's name. You can't turn on each other. You can't say, well, you have to have pride. What goes in the dressing room has stayed in the dressing room. Pull together, you guys. It's against the world. And they've lost three games in a row. They were in the game. You got three times in the draft coming up. Don't worry, boys. You're going to get McDavid. Hang tough. Don't panic. Let's not fire. Let's go like that. Keep bugging along and keep trying the way you're trying.
90 seconds. You want to just talk Jean? Or do you
want to? Yeah, we'll talk Jean. All the rest of the beautiful stuff I have. Anyhow, you know, I knew Jean. The very first time I ever saw him was when I played against him when I was playing for the Boston Bruins. Let's see the picture. My claim to fame that I always kept the picture. I knocked John down here. That's Long John Henderson, the goalie. I knocked him down here. And I tell you, boy, I used to meet him at the playoff. I used to play all the time. And there we are in the Texan across the forum. And watch who is looking over my shoulder, John Béliveau. You know, I used to see him all the time we used to have the banquets and stuff like that. He used to be there all the time. It was unbelievable. What a guy. Class guy. You know, you keep hearing great class all the time. Class. And he was regal or something like that. And, you know, the picture I love of him, and this is a picture I think we'll go out on. I wish we had more time, but I should have said it. Look at this picture. Is this not one of the greatest pictures you've ever seen? I think it's in Montreal or Quebec. Look at that there. He always had time for everybody. That's the thing that everybody talks about. Dick Irvin talks about. He always had time. Look at the little kid. Beautiful, beautiful guy.
Well, Grapes, you were a little boy who loved Ken Reardon, of course, who got told Blake to be the head coach, that Jean says he was the guy that steered our ship. But, 1955, for the kids watching, they don't know. I mean, you play in the National Hockey League. You get one game. It happens to be at the Forum in Montreal, in the NHL, in the Stanley Cup playoffs. with the great John Beliveau. That is a...
Well, and then my big claim to fame, too, is that I knocked him down. I was hoping I'd get a penalty because I would be in the penalty. But like I say, he was a class guy, and, you know, you hear that word all the time, and God love him, he's the best guy. One of the nicest. You ever talk to everybody, they'll say the same thing.
More on that hometown hockey tomorrow and all week long. Shed a tear for me, Don Cherry, on the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada on Rogers.